Degree progress makes knowing what classes to take much easier. There are some things you need to keep in mind, especially if you plan on earning a bachelor's degree someday. Tip number one, understanding the credits per hour ratio for in-person and online classes. There is one in-class hour per credit. Just because a class is listed as 3 hours a week doesn't mean that's all of the time you'll need to invest. For every hour in class, you'll need to figure about 2 hours out of class and then add the two together for the estimated total time commitment for that class. So 3 hours in class plus 6 hours out of class equals 9 total hours. If you're taking an online class, there is no in-class time, but there is prep time. Prep time is typically calculated as 1 hour per credit. A 3-credit online class would have 6 hours of out-of-class time plus an additional 3 hours of prep time for a total of 9 hours a week. So if you're a full-time student taking 12 credits, you're looking at approximately 36 hours of coursework per week. If you're a part-time student taking 6 credits, your time commitment is half that at 18 hours. Do not commit to more than you can handle, especially if you have other obligations such as a job or family. Tip number two, check to make sure you meet the enrollment requirements for prerequisites. If you do not meet the class prerequisites while enrolling, but feel you do, you can submit a requisite review request. Keep in mind that this takes time and will delay your enrollment for a course. Be proactive and make sure that all your transcripts and placement scores have been submitted and are on file. Tip number three, if you are interested in transferring to a 4-year institution after completing your 2-year program, you will need to take the General Education 20-level course options listed in your degree progress report. For example, Written Communications versus English 1. Which class you take depends on if you plan to transfer or not. If you're in a program, Written Communication prepares you for your career, writing, and communicating in the workplace such as drafting memos and business proposals. If you're considering earning a bachelor's degree anytime in the future, you should take English 1 because it's considered a college transferable course and prepares you for researching and writing college papers. The same goes for math courses. There are different tracks of math courses based on your desired career outcome. Tip number 4, transferability. By being a part of the liberal arts transfer program, your credits can transfer to colleges and universities across the country. Other Madison College programs may transfer to some 4-year schools, but the options are limited. If you're not in the liberal arts transfer program, but are interested in earning a bachelor's degree, visit the Transfer Opportunities webpage where you can look at transfer opportunities by Madison College program or by school. If your goal is to transfer to a private college or to an out-of-state school, you'll need to contact that school directly for guidance in selecting courses. Another helpful option is to research the school's website for admission and major-specific requirements. If you plan on transferring within the University of Wisconsin or Wisconsin Technical College systems, you can find helpful resources with our Transferology tool. You can find additional resources on our Madison College website along with transfer-related events and transfer and faculty advising services.
So when you're planning your schedule, keep the tips from this video in mind. Don't commit to more than you can handle. Understand the credits per hour ratio and plan enough time for class and study. Plan ahead. Review enrollment requirements for your upcoming classes to be sure you are prepared. Be transfer ready. Prepare for your next steps by understanding whether a class can transfer. A, 20-level classes generally transfer. And B, check with your 4-year transfer institution early and maximize your Madison College career. Need help planning your classes? Connect with your advisor through the Navigate app.